Okay, so we are on the draw. We have all ramp guys. And we got a scry land. You know, I'm gonna keep this. We just need one of our big guys, and this is a pretty strong hand. The sequencing with this hand's gonna involve playing a turn one Elvish Mystic into something. Oh well, now he has Thoughtseize, but this hand is pretty good against Thoughtseize. He's probably just gonna take Elvish Mystic because it leads to the most explosive draws. But if he goes ahead and does that, then we can obviously just play Temple Abandoned. Oh, okay, well. Just gonna play the Mystic. So, like, if he has a Thoughtseize here, I mean, it's probably better just to wait, like, another turn. Oh, if he plays a scry land, but I don't know, like, Thoughtseizing away a Redaclaw Mystic seems fairly weak. Okay. Sure. I don't exactly know what his hand is, but it's pretty unlucky for us. Although, to be fair, we wouldn't have been able to cast the Genesis Hydra anyways. Like, if he had the Thoughtseize and waiting till, like, turn four, we still wouldn't have our guy in play, so. Yeah, I'm gonna keep that on top. We have basically two more lands in our hand, so we need as much action as possible. Probably doesn't have Drown and Sorrow here, but he could have Bioblight. Okay, so now he's representing like Hero's Downfall. I could play a Xenagos. I feel like if he had, well, because he knew what we had in hand, maybe not, but let's see. I can play a Xenagos. And just make a guy and then force him to Hero's Downfall. Or I can play like a Morph Redaclaw Mystic and attack with this Mystic. And then he, what, like, so let's say I did that. He'll end of turn kill my Morphed Redaclaw Mystic. We get in for two. Then he can like untap and play a Siege Rhino. And then we can play a Xenagos. That's not great. But the upside is if he chooses not to kill our morph, then on the next turn we have access to 3, 4, 5, 6 mana, which is still actually not quite enough to cast the Hornet Queen. See, if he had a Hero's Downfall, would he have used it to try to slow me down? Eh. That'll run out the Xenagos. Well, it's actually interesting, like, as to whether or not I should make a guy here or produce mana, but I think I'm just gonna go ahead and make a guy. That way, even if he has a Hero's Downfall, we're at least gonna have a Satyr token out of the deal. Here's to hoping he doesn't have Downfall and it's just like Abzan Charm or something. It is Abzan Charm. Wait, no. Oh, jeez. Boon Satyr? Oh my god. That is a blowout. But because he was at such a low life total, I think it was still correct to do that, but yeah, he gets us real good now. We could have just not attacked with the Satyr Wayfinder. Now he's probably just gonna play some kind of a mid-range creature here. Oh, nope. So he could have another Boon Satyr, but let's see. He's at 10 life though. I think. Let's see. I like attacking with these two. Could have a removal spell. Nope. Oh, it's a Dromoka's command. Let's see, what's better actually? Facing up both? If I face up both, I have access to 3, 4, 5, 6 mana, and I have more pressure on the battlefield. It's worse to Bioblight. If I face it down though and he kills it, that's also not great. Like if I face it down and face it up, that's three, four. That's still six mana. And I'm just gonna face up both. This just makes it so that it's more difficult for him to attack me. Really want to get this Hornet Queen on the battlefield, if possible. Spells are getting me good. Could be another Dromoka's Charm. No. White, black, green. Siege Rhino. It's just a Siege Rhino. Just to see. Well, Siege Rhino is actually not bad here. Think I would attack if I was him. Also, I would have attacked before casting the Siege Rhino, because you know for sure it's going to resolve. Like, for example, I might have considered double blocking, assuming I had nothing, and then he could have blown me out with a removal spell or an Abzan Charm, and because he played it main phase, it makes me think that he probably doesn't have a removal spell or Abzan Charm. Almost anything is good here. All right. So yeah, let's go ahead and get our forest. And play a Hornet Queen. And Dragon Lord Atarka would also be great here. Both of them are very good. Just because we can. So yeah, now we have some fairly strong top decks. So Hornet Queen gives us a ton of devotion. So Genesis Hydra is great. Obviously Atarka is insane. So we have seven cards that are really, really strong. Polukronos is also just pretty good. So like four mana, three, four, five, six. So we have three, four, five, six. So six, seven, eight, nine. We have 10 mana. What is this? It's a morph. Could be a Den Protector, I guess. We can't really attack us. Jeez. Oh my goodness. Yeah. All right. Well, that's the devotion deck. Sometimes you top deck a bunch of mana sources, and sometimes you top deck Dragon Lord Atarka. Let's go 3 and 2. And yeah, that's game. That was a Den Protector. Okay. So, I mean, I think Abzan Aggro is supposed to be a decent matchup, but we will see how the games play out. So again, don't want Arc Lightning and then Leah's Disciple. The thing with this deck is it's so degenerate. Like, anytime you're adding something out of the sideboard, you're like taking something out that like, you know, speeds up your deck, because that's all this deck wants to do. It's play ramp spells and big cards. So I think we want a sideboard kind of similarly to, you know, kind of the last opponent. He's kind of playing a mid-range deck, so I think Den Protector is good. Arbor Colossus is strange, cause so, like, it's definitely a reasonable card, because, you know, it's just bigger than all their creatures, but it's a five mana card that just dies to like all of their removal spells. I actually do like Ugin against them. Oh my god, I kind of like all of these cards. Let me figure out how I want to sideboard. Hornet Nest is probably bad. Let's see. What's better, Nissa or Arbor Colossus? Nissa's probably not good either, because they're actually the deck that's attacking your life total. But so Nissa's probably bad. Maybe Xenagos is bad as well. And what else is bad? I do like the boom booms, the fatty boom booms. And I do like Death Miss Raptor. Maybe a hornet nest is also good. It's weird because like I almost want to take out some number of Genesis Hydras, just because it might be like kind of the slowest of the bunch, where like a Resolve Dugin is generally just game, going to be game. All right, I'm gonna try without hornet nests, but that could be wrong, so I'll try it like this. It's a lot of fat creatures with two Hydras, the Ugin, and then a couple of Colossus. These might be bad though, but it does block Wingmate Rock and stuff. Actually, the more I think about it, our late game is better, but Ishimoku's command. But he can just kill this, so I can't hide behind it for too long. No, I'm gonna try it like this. Hornet Nest more suited for like the red green matchups, but or even green white, but could have also taken out land, I guess. So one land, three ramp spells. Yeah, I'll keep. You just gotta believe. You know, it's not like I only have one ramp card. It's like he's probably taking the Caryatid. Just needs kind of one land to get there. And we have two draw steps. Actually, either one of our 23 lands or an Elvish Mystic, although Elvish Mystic's not like going to be insane. It's kind of strange that he took that Genesis Hydra, so maybe I am incorrect at evaluating how good the Genesis Hydra is in this matchup. Alright, let's go ahead and play a Caryatid so we can't mess with our mana. It is possible that this might just be too slow. And maybe Genesis Hydra is better than Ugin just because it puts like two threats onto the field on the battlefield and doesn't cost 8 mana. Okay. We are getting beat down. Let's see, so if we morph and then play a land, and let's say we draw another land, that's 4, 5, 6, 7, that's 7 mana. Does not get us to Ugin just yet. We can play a Courser and try to gain a little bit of life. No, that's not that good. See, so next turn, if we play both of these face up, we're gonna have 6 mana. And we draw a land. Gonna take 6 this turn. All right, I'm just gonna play double Rattleclaw. And then basically, our plan is to just try to survive and then play an Ugin and hide behind it. But he does have access to Hero's Downfall. That's the awkward part about playing Ugin in like a devotion deck is you play it and then you just lose it. Like both players just lose their entire board. This is a lot of damage that he's putting on us this turn. Seven damage. Now, hopefully he doesn't have a removal spell, because then we can play Whisperwood Elemental and actually be able to chump with the token. But because he knows that we have the Whisperwood Elemental, might be kind of difficult, if you will. Yeah, I feel like he's got some kind of a removal spell here. And if he has a removal spell, I think it's better to try to play multiple threats in a turn, because I think it's likely that he has Abzan Charm. So I think I'm going to play a Course of Kruphix here. Hope to hit a land. Nope. And then we can play a Morph. And then just pass. This is a Boon Seder. Okay, we're gonna have to do some blocking. All right. This is a far more aggressive draw. Ultimate price. We have to block. He's going to put the guy there. So I guess we'll just block the biggest thing. But I think we're just dead. I guess we get to play a Whisper with this turn. No, and then we just no, we have we ha we'll have three blockers. Yeah, so the planeswalkers are bad. Let's see, so Whisper here, this guy here, this guy here. Could have tried to kill Boonseeder, but I think killing Anafens is a little bit better. Ooh, dead. All right. Let me rethink my sideboard strategy here. All right, so we're all in on the ramp plan, so I don't want to cut any of that. Think Arbor Coloss doesn't do enough for the 5 mana. Let's see. Just got Plummet. Maybe I want the Genesis Hydras, take out the Ugin because he probably has Downfall. So like, yeah, I'm not exactly sure when I bring in the Ugin. I feel like this is the matchup where you're supposed to. Maybe you do. Maybe I just, now that we're on the play, it's not going to be as bad for us. Like I said, I don't think the Planeswalkers are that great because all of his guys can attack through it. At the same time, they do. The Xenagoses do kind of provide chump blockers, and then also like allows us to ramp. So, and they were good game one, which kind of makes me, question whether or not I want to have them in the deck. But this seems like a reasonable strategy once again. He had an aggressive start that game, but I think it's possible that the Hornet Nest is something you bring in on the draw because they're aggressive and you might need that speed bump to prevent them from attacking. But I think on the play, you're going to be putting pressure on them with all of your threats. And for that reason, I'd rather have something other than the Hornet Nest. But I'm trying to figure out if I want the Ugin or if I want the Xenagoses. I think I'm still going to try the Ugin just to see how it goes. That's a mulligan. No ramp. Jeez. Yeah, I mean, you have 12 ways to ramp, and if you don't have any in your opening hand, it's very, very unfortunate. I'm going to keep this though because I don't really want to go to f actually ugh. Yeah, I don't really want to go to 5. So, Yeah, I'm just gonna lead with the Rugged Highlands and try to get a little more information. I know we need a ramp guy, but actually, we really don't. Like, we have a good chance of drawing one, and just want to play this courser on three, probably. Do we want that on top? Probably not. I mean, we have another scry land if we really do want to find lands, but the good thing is if he plays a Thoughtseize this turn, that means he's not playing a threat in turn two. So I do like that. All right, so he's got the Death Dealer. Let's play the Courser right here. Thoughtseize now. He must have another untapped land, right? Otherwise, he sh the sequencing is not not that good. But that deck does play a lot of tap lands. Kind of just wish he doesn't have one, just for max punishment. Looks like this courser is sticking around for at least one turn. Well, I guess he can still just go land ultimate price. Oh my god, yeah, he messed up with that Thoughtseize. That was pretty bad for him. Well, what do I want to do this turn? Kind of want to play this tap land, but this courser doesn't seem like it's the worst because it boosts our devotion. It allows us to gain two life for every land that we play. But let's see, if I play this temple, that gives us 4 mana. Elvish Mystic is 5, and Woodland Hills is 6. So maybe I'd rather just be drawing a large threat out instead of the Courser of Kruphix. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I could also just not play the Temple of Abandon this turn and save the scry and then play a courser. I'm trying to think if I have like, well, but I have draws like Whispered Elemental, which are really strong. Alright, well, first things first, I'm gonna attack because I don't think he's gonna make that same mistake, and we're never blocking with the Courser of Kruphix. All right. Think he's gonna start putting pressure on us, so I'm gonna bottom this. That was good. So don't know if the 2 life points that he missed out is going to be relevant, but 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Yeah, the magic number. I guess we have Ugin in our deck, but honestly, if we just can get to 7 mana sources, we have obviously our Dragon Lords and whatnot. But even, you know, that's also a good number for Genesis Hydra. I mean, ideally, you want to do it for, I guess, 8, but if you do it for 5, you can hit Whisperwood Elemental and Pelucranos. Must be pretty interesting for him, because he's kind of in that situation of like, he probably has a removal spell, so he probably should wait because of the Whisperwood Elemental. I don't know. I still feel like I need to play it. I mean, is that right to slow roll it? He got in his two. Okay, so yeah, that's very good. So yeah, I don't have any interest in shuffling that one away. So I'm just going to attack with the Courser of Krufix. Hopefully he plays a Boonsader to trade. But let's play that. And play this. It's kind of funny because like I can choose to I think I have to play it. Just because we have a Pelucrus coming up and a Dragon Lord Zatarka, and if he has a removal spell, because he probably has a bunch, he can still also just kill Courser of Krufix. This is pretty nice. You know, we got that Atarka in our hand, and I don't think he has a Thoughtseize, so it's a much tougher spot for him. He might have Dromoka's Command. Yeah, okay. He does. You see, what he should have done, I guess it doesn't matter, but he could have put a plus one counter on his guy and just make me sacrifice and keep up mana or something, but this also works, I guess. Oh, he did have Thoughtseize, jeez. All right, well, it's going to be really hard to beat this draw. Just gonna have to top deck, that's all. Yeah, I mean, if it doesn't have a removal spell for the Pelucranos, still a sizable threat. We can monster sit for two. If we draw land, we can monster sit for three. So, but he's got two cards in hand. I don't know. Alright, so we can't really block here. Okay. Okay, so it's Den Protector getting back ultimate price. Isn't he just dead? Yeah, I think he's... Well, no, he's not, because he can... No. No, he's not dead. Excuse me. So, no, he can Dromoka's Charm. Well, I'm going to Monstrous this for three, I think. And if he has ultimate price, I think he would have used it. So yeah, I'm trying to figure out what he could have. Doing it for three means it so that... Okay. Alright, well, ultimate price, blowout. This way, even if he puts a counter, we're still okay. Okay. Attack you. And... Yeah, I don't understand that really. I think he should have played a little more defensive because he had then protector. So he probably should have like morphed it past keep up regeneration. No, then I can still blow him out. Yes, all right. Big dumb monster getting it done. So, yeah. Still not 100% sure on how I should sideboard there, but made it to the finals.